Yesterday and today, we had wonderful sessions, very enlightening sessions in the college. Then I realized what is the value that he speaks. And I tell you, all of you, each one of you sitting here, you will have a wonderful experience today. You will have take home today something new. And all of us will work. And all of us will have families. And all of us face challenges in our day-to-day life because we have to balance work, family, and different other things. And today we have an apt topic and an apt person where Dr. Spurgeon is going to speak about family and work-life interface. Wholeheartedly to NIPM Mangalore chapter.
From where you can learn some tips to have this in your mind. And most of you will enter into this arena very shortly. You will enter into the workplace and you will also enter into the family. And when you presume something, assume something, what happens is that you are afraid of taking these two roles together. And I have seen people, young people, because they have so much of work and they have so much of pressure in the work spot, they delay their marriages. Are you with me? And also, I have seen people, because they have so much of work, both of them work together, and they have a lot of time they have to spend on the work, they delay the childbirth. This is also has become common. I'm not talking something without any statistics. I know the people. The pressure is also mounted. There are some of the companies which also insist on that. You know that there are companies which insist that you should not have a child. No, that you will not, you should not take that. And that's one company I was really shocked. Then I spoke to that human resource manager because one of my own clients that she called me and spoke. She said that after the marriage, the company was not happy. And the company asked her to produce non-pregnancy certificate every month. Which is actually ridiculous. You know, it's against human rights. Which is, in fact, it's ridiculous that, but our people accept it. They produce that. I really got shocked and angry and called that human resource manager and fired him. But that will happen, nothing will happen. Yes, he has nothing to do with me. I can only shout at him and leave. So these are the pressures which we have in front of us. And the pressure is also mounting up that you may not know 30, 40 years back when we were children, there was not much pressure. My parents or my grandparents, they did not have mixie at home. And they did not have grinder at home. They did not have any vehicle, motor vehicle, because my father had only bicycle. But both my father and mother, they worked as school teachers. Both of them used to go by cycle. So not much, many, and no instant food. But with all that, they also had time. They did not have any servant to take care of. As me and my two sisters, we were all brought up by my parents. They had time because we had joint family system and the pressure was not much on them. But that is not the case now. You have all the facilities. You have washing machine, you have a grinder, you have mixie, you have microwave, you have car to go fast, and you have instant food. With all these, we always say we have no time. We have no time. It's not a fault, but it's a matter of pressure. Not much pressure in the work spot in those days. And not much pressure in the home also. Because in our cooking system, that in our family, I still remember that my mother used to cook only in the one time in a day, morning. And all the three times we'll eat something. And the non-vegetarian food was a rare commodity in those days. But now that is not the case, that the children may not even touch the food if there is no non-vegetarian. That's the world in which we live. So the pressure on the mother or pressure on the father is increasing at home. And they were not bothered. We studied in ordinary schools. But now that is not the case. You need to put your child in a good school. You have to find a school by which you have to travel 10 kilometers or 8 kilometers. Pressure is mounted. You get the point, and in the work spot also you have so much of pressure, and the competitions in which you live adds pressure both in the home as well as in the work spot. I was talking to one of my friends whose son recently passed 10th standard. 10th standard in board exam in Tamil Nadu, its maximum mark is 500. So out of 500, I asked him how much he got. He said, not very good marks. Then I was thinking that maybe he didn't get good marks. Asked him how much he got. He said 484 only out of 500. 484 only. Then I really got annoyed, you know, I got angry. I told him, you fellow, remember that if you total your mark and my mark in 10th standard, that's less than this. Right? See, people were not worried. I still remember my sister was first plus two. My younger sister was first plus two in Tamil Nadu, which was introduced 30 years back. Plus two system. And the first 10,200 marks. Out of 1,200, she got 900. We celebrated, I still remember we celebrated because we said that she got a very good marks. She was not school topper and all. But 900 was a good mark, 75%. We were all happy. When my daughter same goes, she has done plus two last year, she passed and she got 1139. The same sister was calling me and asking, why only 1139? Then I told her, you got only 900. Right? So this is a pressure. You have pressure from all the sides. Say that's unnecessarily human beings have added pressure to our own life. It's not that all those who got 1100 and above are going up and up in their life, or it's not that all those who got less mark are not doing fit, become fit for nothing, not that. You take any case, analyze the case and do some statistics. I don't say that you should not study well. Don't mistake me because you're all students here. That's not my intention. I say that we have added pressure. We have put pressure, so much pressure on children, we have put so much pressure on family members and the work spot, they also put pressure on you. This target fixing was not a conquest 30 years back. No, that who understood target? Right? Now you have to achieve a target. And promotion is, say, we lived in a world that 30, 40 years back, if you enter into a job, that's all, finished, you will retire. Whether you work or not, you will get your increment year after year. And on the age of 50 or 60 or 55, you will retire, you will get your pension. But that's not the case now. You have pressure unless you prove yourself. You have no guarantee. Do you get the point that that's a pressure? So pressure you have on both the sides. So when pressure is mounting off in both the sides, what you do, we take one pressure to the other and this pressure to this place. That spoils both. That spoils both. I'll give now examples. We are hurt in the family. When I'm hurt in the family, if I don't heal it, no, if I give back, that's gone. But I'm not able to give back, so I carry the hurt and carry that to the office. And I'll spoil my career there. And I'm hurt in the office sometimes. The boss fires me. I have so much of hurt inside. I bring it home. I cannot give back to my boss. I bring it home. I put it on my wife and my children. Then I spoil my family life, family relationship. When nothing can happen, when the pressure mounts up, I decide, okay, let me end my life. What is there? After all, I have studied well, I did well. I got a good job, I'm earning, then why should I live now with this pressure? You know that 1 out of 20 in IT companies, they have that tendency to commit suicide. It's a statistics. 1 out of 20, especially among women, 1 out of 20, what's the percentage? It's 5, isn't it? 1 out of 20 is 5%. Highly educated people, engineering graduates, working in corporates, receiving reasonable amount of salary, they have this tendency. And we also have cases, 30 years old woman leaving a 2 years old boy in the bed and committed suicide. Had a little quarrel with her husband and the husband did not understand it, committed suicide. So this is the world in which we live, for which we need to have a balance. Then another level is influence. Influence. You take the influence from home to the office. I was talking to a women's college lecturers and ask them one question that you take for example, suppose if you have a quarrel with your mother-in-law, which is quite common in Tamil Nadu, mother-in-law and sister-in-law. If you have a quarrel with your mother-in-law gives you nicely, you are not able to give back, you take the hurt and you are entering into the classroom. And with that in your mind, you enter into the classroom. In the first row, a girl is sitting and that girl resembles your mother-in-law. What will you do? You know what is the answer? They said that we'll finish her off. What did they say? We will finish her off, sir. Is it fair? Simply because she resembles your mother-in-law, can you consider her as your mother-in-law and treat? So this happens naturally for a human being. When you have a hurt in one place, you transfer the hurt in another place. And another example I give you. One of the couples, they came to me. And the girl was saying that, my husband is suspecting me so much, sir, that we don't have peace at home at all. And we spoil the weekends. Then I talked to them and I talked to the man separately, and after some time I found out, which is very interesting. It's a case study, I will present it to you, you decide. He said that in Chennai city, the weekend parties was very high before recession time. It has come down now. The weekend parties have come down now in Chennai city, but the before recession, recession is 2008, you know. 8 or 7, 8, you know. Before that, it was very high. Every Friday evening, you will have parties in almost all the resorts in the ECR, East Coast Road in Chennai. And in that hotels, when they have the parties for the corporate companies, they will also serve drinks. That was very common. It's common even now. Bangalore, Chennai, Hyderabad, these three places. And in three cities, girls also drink. Right? Girls also drink. That's also common. Let's accept it. That's also common. Not all. They also drink. And he goes for weekend party, his wife also goes for weekend party. Both of them work in two different corporate sectors in Chennai, and they go invariably for weekend parties. When he goes for weekend parties, he saw girls drinking, which was a cultural shock to him because he was born and brought up in a rural area, studied in a college, good college maybe, and then he got into this, and it's the first time he is living in a city life. And in that, when he saw people, girls drinking, he could not take it. You know that it's cultural shock you will have. You know, when you have the cultural shock, you cannot accept. You cannot accept it. Then he tried to probe the case, you know, that he wanted to collect more information on these girls, which is not his business, but he did that. So when he inquired about it, he found out one interesting factor that all these girls could drink, four or five girls gathered together and drink in a table, and those girls studied in one particular engineering college in Chennai. All these girls. And it so happened his wife also studied in the same college. And she also goes for weekend parties. So he concluded that all the girls who study in that college are drunkards, and she will also drink. She is cheating me. Do you get the point? Is it fair? You girls, you tell me, is it fair? It's not fair. How fair it is, you have to, I've struggled hard to make him understand that you cannot jump.